the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Christ calls us to share the heavenly banquet of his love with all the saints in earth and heaven. Knowing our unworthiness and sin, let us ask from him both mercy and forgiveness. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our enemy in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
God our Father, whose Son enjoyed the love of his friends, Mary, Martha and Lazarus, in learning, argument and hospitality, may we so rejoice in your love that the world may come to know the depths of your wisdom, the wonder of your compassion, and your power to bring life out of death. Through the merits of Jesus Christ, our friend and brother, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the prophecy of Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-matured wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-mature wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, God shall ransom my soul. God shall ransom my soul. Why should I fear in evil days, when the malice of my foes surrounds me, such as trust in their goods and glory in the abundance of their riches? God shall ransom my soul. For no one can indeed ransom another, or pay to God the price of deliverance. To ransom a soul is too costly. There is no price one can pay for it, so that they might live forever and never see the grave. God shall ransom my soul. For we see that the wise die also, with the foolish and ignorant they perish, and leave their riches to others. God shall ransom my soul.
Alleluia, alleluia. I have called you friends, says the Lord, for all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you.
Alleluia.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume, made of pure nard, anointed Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She bought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated for a moment. So today we celebrate the feast of Mary, Martha and Lazarus, companions to our Lord. And that Gospel reading describes how Mary, Martha and their brother gave Jesus hospitality at their home in Bethany, just outside Jerusalem. Jesus is said to have loved all three. After Lazarus' death, Jesus wept and was moved by the sisters' grief. He brought Lazarus back from the dead that the glory of God might be shown. Martha recognized Jesus as the Messiah, while Mary anointed his feet and on another occasion was commended by Jesus for her attentiveness to his teaching while Martha served. From this, Mary is traditionally taken as an example of the contemplative spiritual life, whereas Martha, an example of active spiritual service. So as we celebrate them on this day, may they continue to inspire us in our spiritual journey. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, in every age you have raised up holy men and women to reflect the light of Christ and to teach us the way of holiness. Strengthen all Christian people by your Holy Spirit, that we may live as a royal priesthood and a holy nation, to the praise of Christ Jesus, our Saviour. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give to the world and its peoples the peace that comes from above, that they may find Christ's way of freedom and life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hold in your embrace all who witness to your love, in the service of the poor and needy, and those who bring light to those in darkness. We pray especially at this time for those who we know who are sick or suffering. Praying by name for John Ellison, Jessica McCaskill, Carrie Waggett, Doreen Moig, Andrew Garvok, Mrs. Hewitt, Sid Harrison, Pat Middleton, Dorothy Macbeth, Stella Matthews, Michael Hughes, Chris Haynes, John Pike, Anne Taylor, Rod Taylor, Carol Woodfield, Christine, Beatrice Yorston, Wynne Alderslade, Grant and Sheena, Gillian, Mavis, Grant Macbeth, Susan Fisher, Ruth Banks, James Shepherd, Marjorie Carruthers, Brian Henderson, Anne Henderson, Brenda Prophet, Stan, Gary, Jim, Joan Thorburn, Ashton, Marion, Betty Hall, Isla Mohammed, Gary Patterson, Jonathan Hall, June Barris, Irene McConaughey, Judith, Derek Yorston, Tracy, Valerie, Tony, Lisa, Michelle, Marion Wheelman, and any others on our hearts and minds at this time. Lord, in your mercy, we remember in your mercy those gone before us who have been well pleasing to you from eternity. Preserve us who live here in your faith, guide us to your kingdom, and grant us your peace at all times. We continue to pray for the repose of the soul of Ronnie Smith, Anne Stevenson, and Frankie Dunn, and those whose memory is cherished especially at this time: Thomas Hugh Corton, Hannah Heslop, Elizabeth Ann Corbett, Robert Christie, Isabella Appleton, and Mabel Sheriff. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
And now, in a moment of silent prayer, we bring before God our own needs and concerns. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please stand if you're able for the peace. May the God of peace sanctify you. May he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before him at the coming of our Lord Jesus with his saints. And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Father, we give you thanks.
thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will, and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks, because in him you have received us as your sons and daughters, joined us in one fellowship with the saints, and made us citizens of your kingdom. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Granted by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will die. So, Father, according to might, his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Baptist, St. Mary, Martha and Lazarus, and all your saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we worship
in one body.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts, by faith with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name, your servants Mary, Martha, and Lazarus reveal to your goodness in a life of tranquility and service. Grant that we who are gathered in faith around this table may, like them, know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, and may be filled with all your fullness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live at work to your praise and glory. Amen. Please stand if you're able for the blessing. God, give you grace to follow his saints in faith and hope and love, And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.